Hello, everybody. What's going on? This is Will here, and we are back with today's episode of Pokemon Heart Gold, man. I'm officially on my summer break. I am so glad. Oh, my lord, man. You have no idea how glad I am to be done with that. I'm going into business next year. It's going to be a ball, man. My best friend's finally going back to school after a year off to make some extra money. I see good things ahead, man. I see good friggin' things ahead. Now, anyway, in the last episode, we went and caught Lapras. I wanted to show you guys how to get that Lapras in the game, one of the interactable Pokemon. And I also did up the little link trade for the Billy the Voltorb. So there we go. We have our team all set up right now. I've got to turn on battle animations. We're going to the dance theater in Akrotik City, man. Let's see what awaits us. Professor Elm told us to come here. Well, wait a sec. Did I go and, I didn't, man. Oh, I'm so stupoid. Oh, I'm so stupoid, man. After the crash, I forgot to go and get the Master Ball. Oh my god, man. Look at this. I couldn't possibly draw this out anymore by accident. Alright then. Well, let's go and get it, I guess. Good lord. Go, let's just go in here. I just need the Master Ball, man. I've already read all this, so I'll just skip it all, whatever. Don't care. Anyway, so what are we going to do when we go into that dance theater, huh? Well, let me be the first to tell you, dear viewer. We're going to go in there, and the kimono girls are going to start telling us about the rainbow wing that we were given by the director. They're going to start talking about it, also talking about the legendary Pokemon of this game, and... Oh, excuse me. Then they're going to be fighting us in sequence. We have to do 5 battles in a row and survive them. I did not see that coming when I first played the game, and I was not prepared. It took me a while to figure out what to do after I beat all the gyms, because I didn't know what to do. Akrotik. I don't recall everything I tried. I think I tried just going over to the Kanto side to just make my way to the Pokemon League. But I'm pretty sure that you're not able to go all the way through, I think, or maybe not. Maybe this is an optional thing, I don't know. Anyway, maybe it's still optional, but I can't recall. Oh geez, thud. How is this possible? How can I lose to mere kimono girls? Aw, dude, Dinkles ain't happy, yo. You were watching me, Will. Yeah, that's right. I never thought defeating 5 kimono girls would be so hard. I got beaten to a pulp. You must have come here for the same reason, right? Don't get cocky just because you defeated Team Rocket. These kimono girls are insanely strong. Go ahead, see if you can defeat them. But I'm not going back. I don't want to see you win. Aw, dude. Man, I like that extra scene right there. Aw, he's getting so discouraged. You ready, Bumbles? What are you holding? Are you holding another round pebble? Let me just see before we go in. What are you holding on to? Aw, he's holding a flower, and it matches your color, Beedrill. Isn't that nice? That's lovely. Let's go inside. Now, pro tip. If I read online with the guides correctly, I'm pretty sure that in order to bring back Ho-Oh, dude, we need someone with the right bond with Pokemon. We ask Mr. Pokemon to give this mystery egg to whoever showed true- Oh, conspiracy! Oh, snap, yo! The egg was eventually handed from Mr. Pokemon to Professor Elm, and then to you. However, being pure alone will not be sufficient to face the power of this Pokemon. I must test you. Are you ready? I am. Alright. So we have to do 5 battles in a row, and like I was about to say, I'm pretty sure the first trainer is Zuki, right here obviously, yeah, and I think she has Umbreon. Alright, cool. So if you have a fighting Pokemon or a bug-type Pokemon, it would probably be best to start with them. So, as I did right here with Bumbles, we're gonna have Bug Bite, and we're gonna bring the hurt, man. We're gonna bring it. Oh, but not before Confuse Ray. Good. I'm trying to remember what this Umbreon has. Confuse Ray, Shadow Ball, Dark Pulse, and Last Resort, I'm pretty sure. So if we can just, I see nothing wrong here. Good, Shadow Ball. At least you don't get stab off that, so that's something. Yeah, not the strongest attack. Especially against a fellow Pokemon with alright special defense. There we go. Alright, one more should do it, eh? Nope. This is gonna be a 4-hit KO. Good. Oh, good. Alright, and that'll bring me down. Ooh, god, okay. Just as long as he doesn't use Dark Pulse. Oh, nice. I beat him on the third hit there. Okay. I mean, I'll take it. I don't think that's how it should have worked, but I'll take it.
I don't have any Pokemon left.
Yeah, I know. You only had the one. So, I mean, I don't know why you're acting so shocked. Like, you weren't going to have any Pokemon left if I fainted one of them. So, oh yeah, this is the kimono girl that, yeah, she observed me taking out Team Rocket in the well. So see, all these good deeds that we did for all these kimono girls, these were all tests to see if we were pure enough to confront the legendary Pokemon Ho-Oh. A really cool way of tying the story together in what was a sort of open-ended kind of game originally. I think it's a really cool way of tying it together and expanding more on everything. Well, Bumbles is done, but that's okay. Now I'm trying to think here, what would be best right now? Espeon's two highest stats are special attacking and speed, I'm pretty sure, so I think Martha Stewart would probably be best. She'll be able to soak up that psychic attack, and I can hit back with Surf. Perfect. Alright. Yeah, okay. Alright, I mean, not the best. These two are probably the hardest ones, so just because they have moves that like lower your special defense, so their attacks can get stronger over time. It just gets annoying, really, because this will do about 45. This will take me down to about my last third, yep. Figured about as much, close enough to a third. And, but then we'll take her out, cool. Take him out, I'm sorry, I apologize. There we go, nice. Lots of experience to be had here as well. Because originally in the games, you'd fight them at like level like 18 or something. Like you were able to fight them right when you got to Ekrutik. So you'd get like, you know, like 600 experience per pop maybe. But this time we're getting like 1600, like there'll be some nice easy levels here. And I'm pretty sure this one is Flareon. It is, okay, cool. All right, would have rather to have a here, I'll just do this. I'd rather have Martha Stewart out this time, obviously, for for obvious reasons. So we'll do just that. Perfect. There we go. And we're still underleveled, as you can see. I mean, it could be worse, but, you know, not the best. Oh, good lord. Oh, good lord. Do we have, like, healing items or something? Nope, of course not. Never have them when I need them. Because, oh man, that Fire Blast, that'll kill me, I'd say. Yep, figured, okay. Alright, so, looks like we are fighting with Agent Spooner. I could go for Shuckle, because Shuckle is only neutral to fire attacks because of the rock typing. And Shuckle will get a crap load of experience out of this. Alright, Fire Blast, that's fine. I'll take maybe 40%, yep, okay. Guessed about right. Alright, so Swagger. So see, Flareon's highest stat is attack, and Flareon's lowest stats are defense and HP. So if Flareon hits itself, this won't be pretty for it. And it's using special attacks right now, so, you know, whatever. Though now I'm gambling, because I can go for the rest right now. But I mean, oh, nice. Okay, Quick Claw kicked in. Alright. Well, that was lucky. I can reach for a full heal next turn, too, so that I'm not wasting my time sleeping here. Okay, hit yourself. Come on. Show off how much damage you'll do. Come on! Oh, you friggin' son of a... Oh my god, what a waste. Okay. What a waste. You have broken through every single time. Good lord. There we go, okay. Yeah, there we go, okay, perfect. That's what I wanted. Look at that, oh my god, that's ridiculous, man. All right. I knew you were gonna snap out of it right then. I knew it. That's fine, we'll just go for the swagger once more here. Because Shucky won't really be useful in the future, in the next two fights, because the only two left over are Vaporeon and Jolteon. And Michelle Ruff will do fine against both those types, so... As long as when we can get this Flareon out of the way, I'd say we're pretty much home free, so... I'll just gamble here, I don't really care. Yeah, there you go. You killed yourself. Isn't that nuts? That if you got the plus 4 boosts from Swagger on Flareon at full health, it would have one-hit KO'd itself if it hit itself in its confusion. And that's why Swagger's awesome. But of course it has setbacks, obviously, it's a huge gamble. But, oh man, I like it. I dig Shucky's jib, you know? I dig his playstyle. You are Sayo. Oh my god, man, is it Blade Sayo? Is it the guy from Super Ass Smack? No, it's a girl. Well, in Japan, I mean, a lot of guys did dress as girls when they were up on stage. Oh man, what if this is Blade Sayo in disguise, man? How nuts would that be? Alright, oh, well, that didn't work out very well. So Jolteon's two best stats are also special attack and speed, just like Espeon. But Espeon's absolute best stat is special attack, then speed, whereas Jolteon's the other way around. Jolteon is base 130 speed and base 110 special attack. So, yeah, I mean, pretty fast, but I think we'll manage. Let's see. Because, oh, well, yeah, okay. You go ahead and use Double Team, man. I have Magical Leaf, so... Just another situation where Michelle Ruff is the best choice, you know? You know, Aerial Ace is a full accuracy move, but it's not like it's very effective on Jolteon. You got Stab Magical Leaf, though. Go ahead, man, just go ahead. I don't care. Whatever. There we go. Nice, man. So cool. So cool. Thunderbolt? Okay, let's see what a Thunderbolt does. I'm guessing maybe 35%? Okay. About 35. About a third. Not bad, not bad. Definitely manageable. Oh, there we go. Thunderwave. Look at you go. Oh, man. You are pimping right now with your Thunderwave. But I've beaten ya. Now the question now is, was the fourth attack last resort? Makes you wonder, doesn't it? It's making me wonder right now. I'm actually kind of curious. I'm sure that's probably like the running like theme between them all. I bet all of them have last resort as one of their moves, right? You know, encouraging variety. So, I would think, because if the AI is like coded to be higher than the normal trainer, then they would want variety in the moves alongside last resort for a powerful finish on top of being unpredictable in their moves. Because then maybe they might not necessarily go for the coverage move. They might try to spread out their usage so that they can get at last resort. Which is interesting. I never really thought of it like that before. Very interesting. Aw, crap. Did not see that coming. Alright. Well, okay. Yeah, okay. Well, you have a nice move, so I'm basically screwed. Crap, man. Who should I send in? I'm probably gonna die. I'm probably gonna lose. But hey, that's fine. Whatever. Max Revive. I don't know. Don't even bother using it on Agent Spooner. Martha Stewart? See, Martha Stewart might actually be best. Because she resists both. But I don't really have much to hit back with. That's the problem. I think it's my best choice, though. I honestly think so. And I just wasted a max revive on this, so this better friggin' work. Yeah, so we have Surf. Okay. Yeah, so Shucky wasn't gonna be much help anyway, because he just would've... Okay, well, since it has friggin' Aurora Beam, I mean, geez, I guess Michelle Ruff didn't make it all downhill from here. What do we use? I think Vaporeon's ability is Water Absorb, so I can't even use my strongest move in Surf. My strongest move is Confusion. That's my strongest attack right now. Good. So Vaporeon's strongest stats are HP and Special Attack, I'm pretty sure. might be wrong? Are you kidding me? Are you friggin' kidding me? Maybe it's HP and special defense. Might be. What could I do? Oh my god, man, I'm getting wrecked. Especially because you got a friggin' critical hit, you lucky little bitch! Of course. I would have laughed so hard if she got confused or something. I just would have lost it, man. I would have laughed so hard. Yeah, I'm done. I don't know, X special. Gotta raise that special set. Look at me go. Yay! Oh my, are you serious? That doesn't even help. That doesn't even help! Alright, so I have no idea what's going to come of this. Oh my lord. I have no idea. Am I faster than Vaporeon? I am! Okay. Alright, so that'll at least dodge a Surf? Okay. I was thinking it was gonna be Aurora Beam, but... Well, I guess Surf would still be stronger. Because of Stab. Alright. Well, let's see what that does. Is that a one-hit kill? No, not quite. Okay. Could have U-turned out of there while I had the chance, but I'll go for this instead. Aurora Beam. Yeah, now we're going for Aurora Beam. You'd be dumb not to, gotta say. But there we go, okay. So I was just ill-prepared, and it was kind of fluky last time, too. There were a couple unwanted critical hits and stuff, so... Screw this Vaporeon. Should I send Bumbles in to reap the rewards, or should I try it? I shouldn't send Michelle Ruff in. Because she's, well, she's paralyzed, so... Well, what I could do, though. I know what I could do. I could just send her in and then switch out, I guess. There. Because who knows, with Bumbles, even if I could just get one hit in, I might be able to, like, poison him or something. Or, I don't know, maybe one poison jab will do the trick. It's possible. It's a pretty strong move, man. I'll show you. I'll show you what it's all about. Oh, yeah. Oh, dude, nice! Bumbles, man. You are the man. I'm telling you, dude. Michelle Ruff leveled up. Perfect. That is beautiful, man. Level 38. They grow up so fast. No, not yet. Couple more levels, though, and Michelle Ruff will be learning a new move. So I'll have to get the move deleter out to get rid of strength, because we don't need that crap. We were not wrong about you. You are indeed worthy of this. Please take it. The Clear Bell? What is that? Oh, there's some shaking going on. Ooh. Big sisters, I just saw the big shadow of a Pokemon over the bell tower. It could be... No way. Will? We'll be at the Dell Tower. The Bell Tower! Oh my lord! We'll see you there. Okay. The Bell Power. I should have named my Bell Sprout that when I traded it. Instead of Dumbbell. I should have named her Bell Power. If only I could see the future. Oh lord. Well, here we go. We finally got them out of the way. I always found them to be the biggest hill, like, you know, the biggest challenge of this game. In the remake, at least. It's just, I don't know. I guess it's because I haven't had years of experience really learning the battles inside and out. I don't know. I always trip up with those five. I mean, my team isn't the best either, but I mean, I trusted them, and I guess I trusted right. Right, Fero? Asian Spoona? Yeah, man. Give me whatever you're holding, dude. I could just imagine, like, because he's an agent, it could be like, this orange flower will now self-destruct in the next 5 seconds. Like, just like... Okay, anyway. Frig, man. Well, we gotta go in here, because this is how you go to the bell tower, but we're gonna end the episode right here, and in the next one, we'll actually go in here and see what's up, man. So I will see you guys then. We're also... I don't know who I'm gonna throw in front either. Well, yeah, okay, I mean, I can throw those two. I can keep those two in front. Those two, oh my god, what the heck? Michelle Ruff and Martha Stewart need the exact same amount of experience. What? That's nuts, dude. That's pretty friggin' nuts, I've gotta say. Oh, look at those stats, man. Just look at those. Those are beautiful. Friggin' beautiful. Anyway, okay. We'll end the episode. Peace.